number was what, sir?
2222222.
What area is that?
I got an answer machine that can talk to you.
Yeah, man. Shout out to De La. Classic record, timeless record, very, very close to a perfect record. 9.5 on my side. Yeah. I'll let you take the next one away. Swing the Locate.
Yeah, I don't know what the fuck this song was about, man. I listened to this song so many times, bro. I'm like, what the fuck are they talking about, man? What are they talking about, man?
Yeah, I kind of did that. It kind of did that for the rest of the album, but we'll get to it.
Yo, bro, like it's like, yeah, I hate this track. It's extremely dated.
Yo, stop. I'm gonna give you a second to change your wording.
But I do. It sounds, you know, we're revisiting these albums and seeing how they stood the test of time. This track did not stand the test of time. You know, it's a hardcore attempt. But I think this was even bad in 91. Like, this is not, you know, if you put this against Step in the Arena, you know what I'm saying, 91, or, you know, America's Most Wanted. Wow. Yeah.
Why would you do that?
I'm just saying. Cypress Hill.
Don't just say.
We could put this against a fucking Tribe album. I'm just saying, like, this beat does not fucking rock. Again, the beat is really hardcore, but like completely separate from the vibe of the lyrics. And I'm like, were you guys making this song together? Because it sounds like you just like threw vocals on top of this beat, and Prince Paul was just trying to compete with the hardcore trend that was going on. But like, it ain't it, man. This ain't it.
Yeah, I don't even have notes. I knew I didn't like it. I couldn't follow it. I couldn't get into it. Notes. I was just like, well, okay. And I was like, well, let's see what B has to say. But yeah, I didn't even write any notes. This is actually the only song I didn't write notes for. I didn't fuck with it. I don't know if this rating is too low or not. I went with a 7, though.
I went with a 7.
You went with a 7?
Yeah, I went with a 7.
It wasn't like 6.5, terrible. But
yeah, it wasn't trash. My thing is, it probably was better in 91. It just does not age well at all. Like, that milk... That the milk's gone bad. You know what I mean? Like,
the milk's gone bad.
Yeah, it's like it ain't it. It ain't it.
We spent some time in this review talking about our love for Black Sheep, our love for Drez, him being a superior MC, especially at that time. Mm-hmm. And we find him as a feature on Fanatics of the B Word, which they were Black Sheep, Fanatics of the B Word. And the B word being bitch, maybe not in this particular record,
but
in general. So I was very happy to hear Drez on this joint. Nobody was credited as a feature on the album.
Well, I mean, you mean the actual album, like Line of Notes?
Right, on the actual CD. I don't recall seeing featuring.
I looked at the track list online. Drez was on it. Credited online.
Oh, was he? Okay, so maybe I'm wrong. I didn't fish out the CD. How did you feel about the record?
Would you
go with it?
I like the hook. I do like the hook. And I think the beat was tough. Again, it just didn't make a marriage with the lyrics. You know, I think they were trying too hard with the beat. You know, Native Tongue, they love that shit. They love Buddy. They love, like, you know, coining stuff and coming up with, like, you know, euphemisms and, like, different, you know, different coded words and metaphors for shit. They got off on that stuff. Very artistic guys. And, you know, I guess baseball, you know what I'm saying, was a term to use as to say having sex or whatever, like Buddy was pussy, whatever, or sex. But yeah, they did trying too hard a little bit. Again, just didn't really, I mean, it was a good joint, but nothing special here.
It didn't quite curl for the kid.
7.5.
I landed on a 7. Let's have a 7 on that joint.
Okay.
And then we close out with Keeping the Faith.
Classic sample.
Classic sample. Classic record, though?
No.
Yo, for some reason, this album, it ended, it really fizzled out. It started really top-heavy. It had some great moments in between. We got a couple classic De La records. Exactly. I like for an album to end on a high note whether it be just a punch in the face that you didn't expect, or introspective something,
right,
or something that's like over the top.
Suicidal thoughts, or it ain't hard to tell. You know, like,
fam, I won't say another fucking word. You just, exactly. That's what I said, and you just put it to music. I need suicidal thoughts, or I need it ain't hard to tell to close out the album.
Come on.
There is no in between.
There's no, Rick. There we go.
There is no in between.
Yeah, that's how you end the album, man. Seriously.
Word up. What do you have, any notes on Keeping the Faith? Any thoughts about it?
No.
Yo, you stupid. No. So I ended the album, my last three ratings on the album were 7s.
Yeah, I gave it 7.5. I mean, again, I've always felt like this. Even when we were promoting this album, I'm listening to some folks that we highly respect. Like, I mean, Riggs is one. Riggs, my brother, he was like, yo, he was hype. You know, he commented on my story. He's like, that's crazy. This album is crazy. It's a classic. I'm like, all right, but like, I never, even when I was a shorty, I never loved Native Tongues. You know what I'm saying? Like, I was very, very much in the music. You couldn't tell me what wasn't going on. I even fucked with some Jungle Brothers shit, right? But, like, Day Lodge has never really, this album specifically never really did it for me. Fuck with Ring Ring, heavy, heavy. Fuck with Roller Skate, heavy, heavy. Singles were always fucking crazy, which I think gave the album the shine that, you know, they had. But I thought, as far as critically, because the singles were so good, and because it was, like, artsy and the skits were creative, I think, and hip hop was so new, I think people appreciated it just from by default almost.
Yeah.